Where's home for you?
Pearl.
No shit, you live in Pearl?
Yeah.
I live in Pearl.
Really?
Yeah, I'm on Cannon Avenue.
You live on Cannon? I live on Cannon.
Come on, what house? I'm sorry, that's rude. You don't have to tell me where you live.
No, it's fine. I'm 318.
I'm 310.
Oh, yeah.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a nurse.
Oh, wow. I'm Freddie, by the way.
Anna. What do you do?
I'm a projectionist by day, artist by night.
Projectionist? At the theater in town?
See.
Oh, what kind of art do you do?
Comics, mainly.
Like, for kids?
Not exactly. Here, I'll show you. Get the portfolio. Just in my... let me show you.
Oh,
thanks. Sorry. This is, something I'm working on.
It's good.
Hey. Hold on.
What are you doing?
Wait, just one second. We should get together sometime, since we live so close.
Yeah, maybe.
Just a coffee.
Maybe.
Tea? Milkshake? Root beer float? Eggnog? Yoo-hoo? Boba tea?
Maybe, okay?
You're married?
No.
Engaged?
No.
You're a nun?
No. I'm just gonna write for a minute, if that's okay.
Oh, please. By all means, write. You writing about me in there?
Once upon a time, there was a pleasant place called Maryland.
Maryland.
Excuse me, Maryland. And in this land, there lived a knight.
Damn it.
Hello? Jen? silence was driving me crazy. So I've been able to find... Sorry, you go ahead.
No, you first.
Did you find anything?
Uh-uh. I thought about going to the police station.
Right. It's a good idea.
Do you know what you're doing?
No, not really.
Is anyone there? We're broadcasting from Pearl. Can anyone hear me? Can anyone hear me?
Just keep holding that and talk.
Where are you going? Hello? Is anybody there?
Are you holding the button down?
Yes! Hello?
It's weird.
It's not working?
Not only is it not working, I can't even get a frequency.
My TV was just staticky. What's that for?
Never hurts to be prepared.
Do you know how to use that thing?
You kidding?
There's two of us. There may be more, right?
Yeah, they're probably holed up in a mall somewhere, Romero style.
moving.
What?
In the car.
Hasn't been here since I was a kid.
Right, it's the old diner.
Oh my God.
Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Hello?
Hello, sir. Miss? Hi.
Hello?
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 Yeah, I don't think they can hear you. Hey, hi. Hello? Hi. Hey, I'm... Hi, 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 hello, hello? Hello?
This is one of the only places in town that hasn't changed much over the years. Maybe that's why I like it so much. How's it coming?
I hope you don't mind blood.
Ah, you know I have a strong stomach. Can you take a little break? I have something for you. That was my mother's. She gave it to me before she died.
But it's yours.
Not anymore. Happy birthday.
Thanks, Aunt Lou.
Looks better on you anyway.
What happened?
Freddy, I was sitting right here. It was me. I was 11 years old.
Tell me what you remember after the bus.
I woke up in my bed. I went to work. I was late.
I was in my studio. I got fallen asleep there the night before, only I woke up with a full beard.
Like you hadn't shaved in months. Me too. Well, not the beard.
Yeah, yeah, I got it.
Maybe there was an evacuation.
Because of a virus that causes radical hair growth? Besides, I mean, we'd be able to tell if people left in a hurry.
So what are you saying?
Well, something else.
It's moving about 0.08 miles per hour. It's about 5 miles to the center of town. That means it'll take roughly 64, 65 hours to get there.
That's less than 3 days.
Let's get out of here before it gets too close to the car. I think it's affecting the battery or something.
Are you really gonna wear that?
There's got to be a way out. Underground, maybe?
It's not like we have a subway system.
Oh, we have a sewer system.
That goes miles outside of town?
Yeah, well, we need to stock up on supplies just in case.
Listen, Freddy.
Have you considered what if we're...
What? Dead?
You
know, it crossed my mind.
And?
Well, it's a possibility. Yeah, but I'm not convinced that's it. I mean, it could be something else, you know? Like an alternate dimension or a parallel universe.
You're serious?
Yeah, well, it's a possibility.
Okay, then don't you think it's strange that there are no other signs of life? I haven't seen one bird in the sky. I haven't even seen a bug.
Yeah, trust me. I've noticed. What?
I need to show you something. I think this is some kind of recording.
Yeah, it looks like it's recording now. Let me rewind it.
What do we do about this?
Well, clinically, there hasn't been much progress. And the latest EEG shows pretty low voltage activity, some diffuse polymorphic delta activity.
Oh, what does that mean?
Can we rewind it? Can we hear that again?
Activity. What worries me are the fevers and electrolyte imbalances.
Your prognosis?
Well, I don't really see any other options here. We're dedicating room and staff to a situation that, quite honestly, is a closed door. Oh, check that bag, will you?
Yeah.
This is in somebody's room.
Okay, let's give it a few more days. Say until Thursday.
March 17th. Yeah, that works for me.
At least there's no family to deal with.
Well, they're talking about someone's brain. Sounds like they're about to take him off life support.
It's a shame.
I hate it for her. Okay, last chance to wake up, Anna.
Holy shit. If someone was in a coma in this hospital, where would their room be?
What?
Where would their room be? All right, what does it say?
What?
You just check the damn heart monitor for me.
You know, you don't have to be such an asshole.
No, I wouldn't have to be if you just snap out of it.
It's 120 beats.
What does that mean?
It's high.
How's your heart rate?
Why?
Just check it.
It's racing, okay?
Okay. Sit down. Come on, sit down. I've got a crazy idea. Just breathe.
Oh, come on.
I just try to calm down.
What are you saying here? You think
I'm conscious?
This is impossible.
But maybe it is, maybe it isn't.
Where the hell are you going? What are you looking for?
My room. What do you think?
No.
Come on.
This can't be happening. You do understand that this can't be happening, right?
Well, it is happening, isn't it?
God, how do you so easily? And besides, it is not March 14th.
Maybe it is.
That would mean that the bus was 2 months ago, Freddy.
Yeah, and maybe that's why we woke up looking like Wookiees.
No, but this isn't real. I mean, that's what you're saying, right?
No, I don't know what's real and what's not. But the voices we heard were coming from your room, that room, right? And it seems to be recording constantly, like it's live. Maybe we've been out for 2 months.
So why did we wake up today? What happened to the last 8 weeks?
Listen to me. If what they said about you is true, and it really is March 14th, then we've got
3 days.
In darkness. That's why the darkness is moving towards us. In 3 days, everything will be gone.
How do we get out?
I think we've got to go through it.
Have you forgotten that when we get too close to the stuff, we start to feel sick? And the battery in my car starts to die. What do you think is gonna happen if we stay in there too long?
Yeah, well, if you've got a better idea, I'm all ears. Just stick close to me, okay?
I'm sure you'd like that.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, you're obviously hitting on me on the bus, and not to suddenly, by the way.
Yeah, well, that's before I realized you were a complete spaz.
Let's go back!
Wait, look!
seen this before.
Seriously, don't feel well, Freddy. Okay, I know that doesn't mean anything to you.
Yeah, I feel it too. Just give me a minute.
Where do you think this chain leads? Thing you've said to me all day.
Yeah, I think we better get out of here. That one's already been taken care of. But we need to hurry up.
Where are we going?
Well, we know the roads are blocked, but we haven't tried the water yet.
It doesn't seem likely at this point, does it?
That's a great attitude.
I'm sorry. I just discovered that I'm in a coma and I might be dead in 3 days. And now there's some kind of large creature, and not to mention I'm sharing my mind or soul with the...
The what? Comic book geek?
I was gonna say stranger.
What are you doing?
This is where I grew up.
The river's back there.
Hasn't looked like this in years.
Hey, bud.
Listen, your mom asked me to talk to you about what happened at school today.
Nothing happened.
You got in a fight?
So?
They say you stole somebody's lunch money.
That's not true.
Listen, I believe you. But your mom, you know, she's losing patience with you, Freddy. You know, after what happened a few weeks ago and now this.
She just wants to ship me off somewhere.
Well, if you're not careful, she's gonna stop threatening and actually go through with it.
So why don't you do something about it?
She wanted to keep you grounded all day. I talked her into letting you go to the carnival.
How'd you do that?
Don't worry about it. Now, I got something for you. I know you're really not into this kind of thing, but it's a major league ball. It's the real deal. Thought maybe we could go, you know, hit a few.
Yeah.
Maybe later.
I'm just trying to finish something right now.
Yeah, no worries. No problem. We'll just take a rain check. Listen, just stay out of trouble, okay?
Cared about was comics. They're my escape, but I guess I still are.
What kind of comic books did you like?
My favorite were the horror comics. You know, supernatural tales of the paranormal and otherworldly. Love the cliffhangers.
Aren't cliffhangers sort of cruel?
In my opinion, there's nothing like a good to be continued. To be continued is just another way of saying it's not over yet. It's the beauty of it.
When I was a kid, I wanted to be a playwright.
Yeah?
I read these horrible plays. I mean, horrible. And every play I read, I used to pretend it was one I had written. I would critique my impressive vocabulary, my genius plot twists. I've never told anyone that it's stupid.
No, it's not.
Why'd you stop?
It wasn't any good.
That's what they used to tell me.
So why'd you keep going?
Because I loved it. And I discovered that some people are just assholes. How can they pull your life support? I thought that was against the law.
Not if you make it a living well.
Why would you do that?
My aunt raised me. She was basically my mom. Anyway, there was an accident, and she spent the last year of her life wasting away in a hospital bed, unconscious. I never wanted that to happen to me.
I'm sorry. You believe we have spirits and souls? You said soul earlier, that we're either sharing our minds or our souls.
Oh, I don't know.
I always wondered if they are exploring when we sleep, our souls. Maybe that's what dreams are. I don't think we should split up.
I agree.
You know, you can tell a lot about a person from their bedroom.
The last thing I need right now is for you to analyze me. Okay. Let's hear it.
Well, you're very neat. Maybe to a fault. The way you've got your little boxes all organized over there by the wall. Weirdo. I see you. Get a copy of Beowulf down here for a little light bedtime reading. You sleep alone. Always on the same side of the bed. But you keep a pillow on the other side, like it's holding out for someone. You know, you're not alone.
This is the one you were drawing in your room.
Yeah.
This looks just like the door.
Yeah, what if it is it?
Huh?
Look. The keys. The candle.
Okay, if none of this is real, why can't we just imagine ourselves out of here?
I'll try it. I have.
But doesn't make sense, any of it.
Unless it is real. This place, it could exist in some alternate dimension, some spiritual dimension, maybe. I mean, it's obviously a copy of the other town, the one that we live in, but that doesn't mean it isn't real, right? I mean, how do you define real?
I don't know. August 23rd, 1992. That day in the diner with my dad was...
It's the same day.
What else did you do that?
Freddy.
Okay.
Sure.
Okay. How about this one? Looks fun.
Three shots, please.
See what you can do with this.
Don't miss Freddy.
Stop.
Don't miss Freddy.
What, him?
I heard that.
And she's off. Uh-oh.
Hey, when we get one of the police guns.
I'm playing for one thing and one thing only. That Spider-Man comic.
That comic crap's for losers. Nice shot.
For that, I'm gonna need one of those teddy bears.
If you can hit anything.
Maybe I would if you two stop breaking my concentration.
What do you say we go ride the Ferris wheel, and then we go and start on this play of yours?
Deal.
Okay.
Aunt Lou, are you okay?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm fine.
Sure.
Yes, it's okay. Just getting old, I guess.
Ooh.
Do you want to go again?
Nah, forget it.
Doesn't matter. Can't aim for crap.
Come here.
Hey, hey, come on. Break that. Then what do you guys say? We go have some real fun. I met Freddy here. He's never even been to a real haunted house.
Of course I have.
Oh, yeah? Why don't you prove it?
Lead the way.
I guess we just missed each other.
Hey, what is it?
It was the day it happened. After we got home.
The day what happened?
My aunt and I used to perform my plays together in the living room. We had these costumes and props. We took it so seriously. Well, I did anyway. I would pretend there was a full house of a big cheering crowd in the dark. And Aunt Lou would always play along. She was weak, but she did it for me. And in return, I killed her. It was my fault. I set the candles out, and they were too close. And it was my fault, Freddy.
Hey. Whatever happened, it sounds like it was an accident.
No, it was an accident. It happened because of me. It's unfolding in order the day, Freddy. And I don't want to go back to that moment.
Okay, just tell me exactly what happened. This way.
The journey was long and hard, but the knight kept going because he wanted to make the king proud and kill the monster.
Okay, Highway 10. That's where the door is, and the chain anchor. That would mean the chain is roughly...
Freddy.
Half a mile long. Long chain. Here's the radius that it can roam, and where are we? Here. So we're safe.
Freddy. I think I may know what that thing is.
Enter the monster, a big, gross creature that eats people. How old were you when you wrote this?
I told you it was bad.
Okay, so the door from my comic, the monster from your play. I mean, tell me you know how to kill this thing. You wrote the story.
Well, in the story, a knight kills it. But as it so happens, we're plumb out of knights here.
Yeah, well, we can't get through the door until we have the key.
And I suppose you have a brilliant plan of how we're gonna get it? Are you sure you know how to do this?
Yeah, I was kind of a pyro in high school. Okay, we need to make this fast.
Okay.
do you think's gonna happen if we don't get out? I mean, you didn't sign a living will, so you could be okay either way.
Freddie, I think this is just the stakes.
Oh, shit.
What?
We have to get to the core.
Damn it! What do I do?
Destroy it again!
It's dead!
Destroy it! You wouldn't believe how strong this stuff is. I used to rappel off the roof with it.
Been in here in a long time.
Yeah, I still come sometimes just to sit.
That was the 17th.
You know, I never asked you where you were coming from on the bus.
I was on vacation.
And by yourself?
Mm-hmm. It wasn't so bad.
Yeah, I guess we're both hermits. What's your reason?
To miss yours, I suppose.
What, rejection?
I'm sorry I tried to blow you off on the bus.
I just asked you out for a cup of coffee. I guess I got more than I bargained for. Listen, if we don't make it out of here, I just want you to know. Are you okay? I'm not gonna let you die, Anna. So follow me.
Once upon a time, there was a pleasant place called Maryland.
Maryland.
Excuse me, Maryland. And in this land, there lived a knight. His boss was the king, A fat man with a big beard named Lord Dunbury.
Is it true this place is haunted?
You bet it is. It's a hospital in the Civil War. They say the ghosts of all the people that died still roam the halls.
After 3.5 weeks of traveling, he finally came to the monster's secret cave. That's me.
What are you gonna do?
See those wind chimes on the front porch? I'm gonna hit them.
Bullcrap. You cannot hit that from here.
Watch me.
I have come to cut off your head. That's not a very good roar. Much better. Now you will feel my blade, foul beast.
Scare those ghosts out.
Thank you.
Where's Freddy?
Can I help you?
I'm looking for Freddy.
I'm his caretaker. Come on in. Let me know if you need anything. At the hospital. I was so scared.
You were on the bus, right?
Freddie, don't you remember?
He doesn't remember anything. Nothing but being on the bus. That he seems to remember clearly.
This may sound crazy, but I was with him in my coma. We were here in this town. Only we weren't. I don't know.
He's been having vivid dreams, but he only remembers fragments, pictures.
I'd like to stay with him.
How do you know Freddie, anyway?
We grew up down the street from each other.
I don't remember doing any of those.
They're great.
We meet each other before the bus.
In a way.
I feel like I know you from somewhere else.
This is me.